Schwarzenegger's movie, Total Recall. There you go. Nice little Porsche there. We have certainly enjoyed the museum. Bob, thanks for getting us into the museum here. We're going to give a little bit of exposure here with some advertising here. And Daryl, when you get to the back room, there's a 50 Ford convertible in there.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Can't you guys start right here? It's a self-guided tour. You're welcome to take pictures. Some vehicles throughout the museum are sold out. If you're interested, just check out the bottom right of that white
seat. Mine are clear of this color. Did you
have a grandma, there's some
more. Thank you very much for the tour here. And if anybody's interested, do you have a card, a business card here that they could call and find out hours and things? And the Branson, oh, this is a Ralph Hurley's photo. Absolutely, Bob and Ralph Hurley, yes, good friends of mine. And here it is, and you can find out about the Branson Auto Museum there and give them a call. And thank you kindly. You have a great day. Bob, thanks for getting us into this nice tour here. And I see you and Ralph Hurley have, this is basically your place. This is your museum tour here now.
Stuart Howden and Ralph Hurley. This is our place, and I just rent the shop in the back, but we work together.
Gotcha, yes.
We all get a chance, we can lose money together.
Hey, that happens. It's much more fun doing it together. Misery loves company, right?
If you have lost money in the car business, you haven't done enough cars yet.
There you go. Thanks again, Bob. It's always great to see you, and the tours and all the storehouse of wealth that you have about collector cars and things.
A toy store or what?
Oh, awesome.
Thanks, Mike.
Thanks, Bob.
Pretty girls in there, too.
I see that. Well, hey, the weekend is about to end, but not quite yet. This is the 300 awards banquet here for all the letter cars and all the people here that did all the polishing all year round, and here we are. The awards banquet here. Boy, we got good food. Hey, Ray.
Hi,
how you doing?
All right, don't
I care. Barb.
Thank you.
And Spanky, you can only have six rolls, that's all. Hi, Donna Marie. Hey, Paladin. Four, only four pork chops. We got to film the lineup, boy. Look at all these hungry folks here. Look at all these hungry folks. All these hungry folks here. Hey, Ed, how's that rotor holding up? Good?
You know, it helped a lot. It really helped. The spark's not getting near as bad now.
Fantastic.
That thing was moving around in there so bad, it was really bugging me. I couldn't figure out what the hell was going on.
It's also giving you a better appetite, too, right?
Well, my appetite's never changed.
Good seeing you, Donna Marie. Paladin, two plates only? I'm on a seafood diet. I eat everything I see. A small one. Well, take a big one, cut it in half, and you got two small ones. They get double your money, right, Lynn?
Yeah, that's very important.
It looks very good. Lynn, what a nice meal. Paladin? Paladin, aren't you glad you came here? Yeah, I suppose this weekend is better than a ride in your squad at 160, yeah? And John, having a good time?
Yep. I was raised as a GI Brat, so I have quite a vocabulary in my...
Reverend Fly, what do you think of the weekend, huh?
Very good.
You didn't put any vegetables on your plate.
Oh, I know. I'm a very bad boy.
Verbunte. Here's our show hosts here, Marnie and Rob Kern here. you back here. Tom Gorth. Hi, Tom. How you doing?
Agenda that Gloria sent me, my own mother hen. She always does this for me. She sets out the agenda. If I can remember to find the agenda. I'd like to thank you all for attending down here in Bronson, Missouri. I never heard of the place before. The fellow that does my engine boring and machine work, he mentioned one day, oh yeah, he says, I go down to Bronson, Missouri. I says, what's the attraction in Bronson, Missouri? That's what I did. And it said it didn't recognize it. And I thought, boy, that's really some place that if my GPS doesn't recognize it. Well, I found out in Bridgetown.
Glenn, he should get it set up for there you are, Ollie, right?
So, again, I'd like to say thank you very much for coming out here. I've talked to Rob Kern, and I haven't yet even spoken to Marnie yet, but I know who she is, and she knows who I am. And they put on one heck of a meet here, as usual. And first of all, let's get back to the thank you, Rob and Marnie. Are we going to do this again next year? While you're down here in Bronson.
Birthdays are special events.
Branson.
Branson. Bronson, Branson, where are we at?
Got a couple of hands up there. Carol?
Tuesday was Andy and I's 10th anniversary.
Anyone else? Anniversaries, birthdays, divorces.
The end of August, we
have
50 years.
The end of August, we have 50 years. Yeah, we were in a little social gathering one night in a local pub. And I brought up the fact, I said, yeah, you know, wife and I, God, 52 years, you know? And a fellow that I knew very slightly sitting next to me, he says, Hal, he says, I got you beat. I says, what do you mean? He says, well, he says, I got 55 years. I says, really? He says, yeah, but it took four women to do it. Something to say right at this time. So, Ray, you want to come up here, please? pass meat card. We had a lot of people arguing out in the parking lot when such and such a meat was, what year it was, or where it was, and so forth. So I went back and through the meat attendance records, I created a meat card, which was a business card. And on both sides, it had dates from the very first meet to the most recent meet. And that ran out around 2000. So I've been having requests for new ones to be made. So I finally made new ones, and I'll have them with me. I've given them to as many of the old-timers that do that sort of thing in the parking lot and been to so many meets. But I do have enough available for if anybody really wants them, and any of the old-timers that need them, and anybody relatively new wants them, I've got them, come see me. Now, you got to fold it. It's two sides, but this one here has all the family members and, you know, a little bit about the club. So, anyway, anybody wants any, wants one, come see me.
Thank you, Ray. While I was in my hotel room in the bathroom pondering the events of the day and the future and all the problems in the world, I happened to, something entered my mind and I says, oh my goodness, how about this? You know, 1970, July, was the first, how would you say, the first meet of the Christ of the 300 Club International in Holly, Michigan. A bunch of guys got together, and when we arrived at that area there in Holly, Michigan, said, oh my goodness, look at all those 300s. Didn't know that many existed. All right, from that day on, there were a number of us. I won't go through the list right offhand because I don't have it in front of me, but we had the people that were basically the founders of the 300 Club back then. And it came to me that we have some of those people here. And those people that are here, I think a lot of you have met and talked to. The first person is Dave Warner. The second person is Gil Cunningham. Now the next one here.
On the Handy Dandy Bar.
There you go. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Arnold Luth. And yours truly. They're so alive. This is, oh my goodness. Y'all got foggy here for a minute. Now that was kind of a memorable day back then, and I thought it was worthwhile mentioning. Because when you start going down the list here, you see a deceased right after a number of these names have gone through the years. The founding members are, the group is getting smaller and smaller and smaller. But those that are here, we're still hanging on. And we still have just as much interest in these Chrysler 300 letter cars as we did back then. We may be a little bit slower working on them now. Or, you know, you can't get under them anymore and work on a suspension. Everything you have to do is tabletop height. I can do that, that's okay. So I just thought that was worth mentioning because, you know, how many times the remaining group of us can get together? And we're still here. We're still here. And still hoping that we can do a job for the club and for the members, and hopefully do whatever we can finding parts and stuff for your cars.
Thank you.
awards. Now we have two groups of awards. One is the concourse, and the second group of awards is the People's Choice. And we'll proceed with that. That'll be the concourse award. Vanna, do you have the sealed envelope here? That was nasty. The 1956 P. And I've ridden in this car. Years ago, I tried restoring a 1955 300 at one of the facilities that I managed. That was back in Ann Arbor. Took a few days off to paint the house. Get a call from my plant manager and said, you better get over here, the building where your cars and parts are on fire. And I says, which building? He said, the one with your cars and parts in it. Well, along with the cars and parts, there were probably 15 cylinders of acetylene, probably 20 cylinders of oxygen, 55 gallon drums of alcohol, and various other explosives. Well, needless to say, I lost a 29 Rio Flying Cloud sedan, a 71 Imperial LeBaron coupe, my 55 300, had the suspension done, the engine transmission done. It ended up 2 feet high off the floor. The heat was so bad, the carburetors were melted right down into the intake manifold. Sad day, but I always thought that one day I'd get into a 55. Currently, Michael Burke and I co-own a 55 300, and we're in the process of restoring that. But back to this. For a 1956 300B to Gerhardt, Red, Phil Irish, would you please come up and accept your award? First place winner, 1958 D.
Yep.
And it's that funny South Seas color.
Tahitian coral.
Oh yeah, Tahitian coral. Daryl Miller. Become extremely enthusiastic in the club I can remember the first time I met them. And I said, geez, I wish that I had that much enthusiasm, you know, back years and years ago. And they have continued to be, how would you say, not only friends, they've made a lot of meets, and they enjoy the other people, and I know a lot of people enjoy them. And I count them on my list of friends. Not only just 300 friends, but personal friends. And this is for a 1962 300H, a red convertible, Ed and Angie Phillips. If you would like to have them back in the box to protect them, you can come up and, you know, put your award into the box that they came in. Now, this one here does my heart good. Years and years ago, I believe it was up in New York State, up in the Adirondack Mountains. And I can remember the scene there just so perfect. There was a pond, there were little cabins, part of the resort there. And there were wild geese, Canadian geese, walking around. And there were a number of cars parked on an angle in front of this small lake or pond, whatever you call it, more of a pond. And the car that I had at the time won a seniors award. And honestly, I was so embarrassed at the time that I've never put my car in the concourse again, because I felt that the awards, the concourse, and so on and so forth was the members. And at that time I was president and, you know, very active in the club and so on and so forth. But from then on, my thoughts were that this club is for the members. It's for them and it's for the car. And I vowed then that I'd never put my car in the concourse again. But it does my heart good to see that there is an individual here with a very, very nice car that I drooled over a little bit today. And I'd like to say that it's one of my favorites too. That car happens to belong to Fritz Crombie. It's a black 1963 300J. Fritz, come on up and get your award. Point value on Fritz's car, 721 points. Not bad, not bad at all. guys at the time of the judging, and I guess this was a very easy judging for the group of judges that were doing the concourse. And unfortunately, I can only recall a couple of them, but I would like to have the judges stand up and let us show our appreciation for them doing this hot and sometimes dirty job. I know, I used to, I think, started doing engine judging, and then I helped out on undercarriage. Well, I had to give up undercarriage. A little bit too much. But yeah, when we have a number of cars in concourse, that is really, really a trial to get the judging done. Because the judges that are given, there are certain categories that they will look over and evaluate and put their points down on the judging form. They become more and more educated through the years. And some people, with their cars being in concourse, they say, oh, you're criticizing my car. It's not the fact that they're criticizing your car, it's the fact that they are showing you areas of improvement according to the way the car came from the factory. That's all it's about. They're just trying to help you. And if you have a question about what points are awarded or what points are subtracted, talk to the judge. Don't tie them up, but you know, ask a legitimate question if you have you think a disputable area that you'd like to clear up. Okay, now I gotta find something here. There's one section here that some people like to get, some people don't like to get. But there's two categories under this. The first one, and I'm gonna have to set something down here to write, long distance. Now, do we have any mileage quotes on how far you've driven to get here? Not flying, not by train, not by bus, but by a 300.
2001.
1143.
I can't hear anything.
Put a battery in it.
2001.
That was 8 years ago.
Where'd you come from? Nova Scotia?
Hawaii.
Hawaii? Swimming doesn't count.
If that was supposed to be a 300, I withdraw. I drove a Dodge.
Withdraw.
Okay, thank you. No more mileage figures?
543.
Oh, Lindsay, what's your number?
If I hadn't stopped at some cellar jars, it'd been 1,040, but I had a few stops, I did 1143. In my app.
1,040.
1,040?
Plus 80 for the salvage
yard. 1,080.
1,143.
1,143.
Did you hear that, Jim? I can't.
1,143.
1143 is the latest bid.
Reverend Ply, I wonder if we can count two times
883.
Two times 883.
60. All right, Jim, you're going to have to be my ears on this one. From where did they come?
Canada.
That's not an American state.